part 3 is about disaggregation and group sets. So in a pivot table, you can include both disaggregated and total data. So for that, of course, you have to have disaggregate data in your instance. So say you have something, some data element recorded, disaggregated by sex as male and female, obviously, then you can disaggregate that specific data element to that male and female component. So DHIS2 allows you to show your data in disaggregated and total formats. So it is very easy. It is very easy. So I will show you. Now we are moving to our demonstration. Okay. Right. Before showing the totals and detail, let me concentrate on this here. So here below the compulsory or the main three dimensions, which are data, periods, and organization unit, you can see a large number of additional dimensions. So these are optional dimensions for to create a pivot table in DHIS2. So data, periods, and organization unit. So those three are main dimensions. So anything below that you can see from starting from age immunization. So those are additional or optional dimensions. So first question is how these dimensions have come to this place. How you can get these dimensions here? Because once you are starting with your instance, you will never get any additional dimension here. Only main three dimension will be available. So additional dimensions can be added in three places, exactly in three places. So when you are creating categories in maintenance app, you are creating categories for data element disaggregation. While you are creating your category, so if you want to, I can show you, there's option to tick whether you want to add that category as a data dimension or not. Shall we go to the maintenance app? And then two categories, right? Here category. So shall we take our category sex? Here's the category sex. Here you can include this category sex as data dimension. So if you click this, this category will be available as an additional dimension in your, for your type pivot tables. So that is one place. The second place is when you are creating organization unit group sets, again, you can select whether to include it as a here data dimension or not. If you select this, so this specific organization unit group set will be available as an additional dimension. So this is the second place. Third place is data element group sets. Here, when you are defining your data element group sets, again, you have an option to select whether to include as data dimension or not. So you can decide to include or to not include. So depending on your decision, it will be shown under pivot table compulsory or main dimensions as an additional dimension. So this is how you get additional dimensions here. Right. So shall we use sort of an additional dimension? Okay. To add additional dimension. So shall I open up a very simple table again, our previous table. Okay, fine. Here, let me change the periods. All right, three. Shall I change the organization unit to district levels? Select here. Okay, all the districts are here. Right. So what I'm going to do is I need to So let me change a little bit of data to make it more visible to you. So I'm just creating the table. Don't worry. I didn't show you anything. Okay. Right. So not the facility. Shall we select one small district? Yeah, bird district. All right, a very simple period. Shall we omit this thing? All right. And let me include periods in column dimension. Right, fine. All right. Now, so here, the number of HIV tests performed. So I didn't do anything, just prepared a table to show additional dimension. So still I haven't used any additional dimension. This is a simple pivot table. Okay, right. So you have a data. So we don't have data for 2015 and 2016. We will discuss options later, but for the time being, I would like to hide empty columns. So they will not disturb us anymore. Right. Right. We have a very simple pivot table. What we are going to do is to disaggregate these numbers as male and female, that is by gender. So to do that, select here, we are disaggregating according to the sex. Put male and female to the right side, so they are getting selected. Here you can now check layout. You have additional dimension. Okay, we can allow it to be at columns. Let's see what is happening. Now earlier, it was only a total number for 2017. But now it is disaggregated for females and males. To see this, mind you, your data element, that is HIV test positive, should have data disaggregation with categories. If you don't implement data disaggregation and you are just collecting a value for the total value for HIV test performed, you cannot do this. You need to have disaggregation for that specific data element to disaggregate like this. So this is very simple. This is very simple. So going further, shall we use this type Also, health facility types shall be, for the time being, dispensary, PHC, okay, that's fine. And shall be health centers also. Then check the layout here. We have type in column. I'd like to get type into row because I want to categorize my organization units according to the type. Just see the output. Now I can see all the dispensaries, all the PHCs and all the health centers. So they are categorized according to the type. The table little visible, I can say show empty rows, and now my table is clear. Now I have used in this specific pivot table two additional dimension. One additional dimension in column, so that is sex, with two options, female and male. And another additional dimension as type in rows, dispensary, PHC and health center. So this is how you are using additional dimensions in pivot tables. So that is very easy. But mind you, although there are a lot of dimensions, you cannot use all because it should be appropriate in your case. So it should be appropriate for your pivot table. If not, you will get a blank pivot table. So you have to have some idea how this data is collected and how these org units are categorized and how these data elements are disaggregated before using these additional dimensions. Right, going back to the presentation. So that is the end of demonstration for part 3.